Outing's over up there. I'd like for you to report to sick bay.
What for?
Well, you're due in surgery. I'm going to bob your ears.
Captain, please go. Somehow, they do not look aesthetically agreeable on humans.
Well, are you coming, Jim? Or do you want to go through life looking like your first officer?
I'm on my way.
From space fantasy to a fantastic reality tonight on BBC One. After its latest visit to Earth, Halley's Comet is already on course back towards the icy wastes of outer space. In an attempt to unravel the mysteries of this ethereal visitor, the fragile spacecraft Giotto has traveled for 7 months in space and is due to enter the dangerous bow wave of the comet tonight at 11 o'clock Earth time, when you can see live coverage of this once-in-a-lifetime encounter on BBC One. Well, now on BBC Two, a somewhat less hazardous occupation, but nonetheless very rewarding, as we join Tony Soper, discovering birds.
Lovely weather for ducks, you may say. But like a lot of old sayings, it's not true. Ducks don't like heavy rain any more than we do.
In fact, when there's a downpour, they hide themselves away and sit it out. No bird can afford to get too wet. Feathers can take only so much of a soaking. The dividing line between waterproofing and waterlogging is pretty thin. In the cause of parental duty, though, an incubating osprey doesn't have that much choice. Birds may not enjoy getting wet, but one thing's certain. They owe their existence to water, and without it, their daily lives would never be the same. After the deluge, when rain clouds give way to the sun, there are millions of gallons of water lying, standing, and running across the face of the earth. And it's now that the birds emerge to enjoy the liquid they were previously doing their best to avoid.